This is an example of a restoration of an old photo by using a combination of Photoshop and Image-to-Image AI. First, we open it in Photoshop, the photo that we scanned, and we have to rotate it. There are a lot of scratches, missing and blurred parts in the photo. The first task will be to remove the obvious scratches. Working in new layers to be able to check the progress and roll back if needed is always a good practice. Before even starting the scratch removal, I will desaturate the new layer since this is a black and white photo. I will save the image as a native PSD file in order to save the progress as we go. I like to start the scratches removal with one of the rather new tools of Photoshop that can be found in the neural filters, and that is photo restoration. In the course of the restoration, I will use it more than once. Even though we will do a face restoration with this tool first, I will focus in cleaning up the photo. So I will put the enhance face slider to 0 and boost up the photo enhancement for contrast improvement and scratch reduction for the first pass of cleaning up the photo. When ready, I will press OK to make the changes in a new layer. Doing the edit in a new layer will allow me to restore a detail that Photoshop is considering it as a scratch while it is not. By checking the before and after, looks like in this case we can move on. This step will require manual patching and cloning to get rid of wrinkles, stains, big scratches, or even missing parts with little or non-essential details. The new remove tool is a huge time saver for this step since it will do a great one-click job in comparison to the other tools like healing, spot healing, patch, and especially the old good stamp tool. Removing the need to sample from other parts of the photo is huge. Plus, by examining the surrounding area of the photo, this tool is able to generate the selected area by matching its surroundings. I will use other tools as well, like the patch or stamp tools from time to time, however for the vast majority of the strokes the remove tool is used. I will speed up this process. When done with this passive cleaning, I will focus on the faces. In order to restore them, first I will need to clean them as much as possible. Any scratch on the face, the program will consider it as a part of it and will add up some detail. So if there is a scratch, it will restore it as a scar on this face, for example. In order to have a better look on the details of the faces, I will make a temporary curves adjustment layer to pop out as much details as possible from this area of the photo. By adjusting the curve, I will find a position that suits this need and start cleaning the underlying layer more efficiently. We can always readjust the curve to check this area better. When done, since I will not need the curves layer, I will delete it and use the image restoration from the neural filters again. However, this time to enhance the faces. Any unwanted details can be fixed in another step, or I can cancel the enhancement and try to clean up the face a bit more. In that case, I will try to increase the clarity and contrast of the face details before running the face enhancement again. For this photo, I chose to go on and fix the faces a bit more after the enhancement. Same tools as before, remove, stamp tool, etc. After finishing with these fixes, I'll tone down the face enhancement by reducing the opacity of the layer. This is one way to preserve the authentic feel of the photo but at the same time make the faces pop out a bit more. Despite reducing the opacity, there are still edges that are sharp and stand out from the rest of the face. With the blur tool, I will make these edges blend better and be less apparent. With the basic cleaning done, I will focus now on dodging and burning in order to increase the clarity of specific areas of the photo. More clarity will help the image-to-image that we will run later for better regeneration of these parts. The man's and especially the woman's feet lack contrast and clarity, making it hard to separate them from the background. So, by using the dodge and burn tools, we will lighten and darken areas of the photo. Darken the boots and the shoes and lighten the socks, or just emphasize shadows and highlights to give a bit of dimension to the details. Also, fix some areas, like the hands that are much darker than they should. At this point, I will attempt the first image-to-image regeneration in automatic 1111, with the use of the SDXL model. To do so, I will export the image at a size more suitable for SDXL image generation. That is 1024 pixels wide and 1536 pixels height. This is not necessary, since I will use low denoising strength, but still since the purpose of this step is to help generate some details and clean up the image some more. It won't harm to maintain one side at 1024 pixels and the other 1.5 times that. The first step in the automatic 1111 in the image-to-image tab is to interrogate the photo in order to help us with a more proper prompt and after the prompt generation check to see if we can edit it, to improve it. The prompt, after all, is what will drive the generation and will help to improve the photo. For the generation, we will use 35 steps and test with various values of denoising strength. Denoising strength of 0.25 will have much less impact in the generated image, and higher values around 0.45 or even more will alter it more and more as we increase this value. When ready, we press generate and wait. When the generated image is ready, I saw that the initial edited image needed some more basic additions, since especially the lower right of the image lack information for the model to generate details. Even with higher denoising strength values, so going back to Photoshop to try to fix some of the issues. To generate some details in this area, we will use the generative fill that will use the Adobe's Firefly model for the generation. I also tried to improve the legs of the woman. After that, I will export the image and try again in automatic 11:11. With the new improved photo and a change in the prompt, I will make another try. This step may be repeated to check results until we find an acceptable result. The second generation is better, so I will save it and overlay it above the photo as a layer in Photoshop. By masking and inverting the mask of the top layer, we can control which parts of the photo we want to affect by using a low flow brush on the mask these areas. By revealing the top layer from the automatic 11:11, we clean or reveal details that we want. After we are done with this process, we might want to save the output and repeat an image-to-image generation. The goal is to keep it under control in order to maintain the feel of the image and improve it with each cycle. The main focus of the last generation will be the woman's feet and shoes. I will increase the speed of this step since it is a repetition of the last. After the last generation, the result is better, and I will do some last edits. Here I can inspect the result and decide if I want to make more changes or not. One final step for this example will be to enhance the contrast a little bit by using a curves adjustment layer. And here is the before and after for this photo.